Our topic for today is about underground 13.8 KV distribution system using radial topology. This is the layout diagram. In my previous video, we know that the distribution substation has an output of 13,800 volts. This 13,800 volts distributed by feeder 1 and feeder 2 through an MV switchgear. This feeder number 1 provide power supply to commercial area. This feeder number 2 provide power supply to residential area. This feeder 1 distribute power through a 13,800 volts AC underground distribution line via MV direct burial cable, this red color. At the end point of this MV cable, it was connected to RMU, to this RMU. RMU number 1, ring main unit. This RMU has 3 terminal. According to this diagram, this RMU has IS1 incoming isolator terminal and IS2 outgoing isolator terminal. There is also a T of circuit outgoing terminal that has a fuse to protect the distribution transformer. Going back to our layout diagram, so we know already that this RMU has 3 terminal. This T of terminal connected to a distribution transformer that has an output of 430 volts power supply intended only for this hospital building. We call it individual distribution transformer because this hospital needs huge amount of power to provide power supply on their machineries and equipment. So from this RMU number 1, it is connected to RMU number 2 via a direct burial MV cable. And also, the T of circuit of this RMU number 2 connected to a distribution transformer that has an output of 430 volts, which is the voltage intended only for the power supply of their machineries, air conditioning, water pump, etc. For this is called building only. So we call this transformer an individual distribution transformer because this is called building need huge amount of power. This RMU number 2 connected also to RMU number 3 through a medium voltage direct burial cable, and then the T of circuit of this RMU connected to the distribution transformer that has an output of 430 volts intended only for the power supply of their machineries, air condition, etc. on this establishment. So these are the components involved in underground distribution system on feeder number 1. Next we go to feeder number 2. This feeder number 2 provide power supply in a residential area through an underground distribution system that using a medium voltage underground direct burial cable. This direct burial cable feeder number 2 connected to RMU number 3. and then this, the T of circuit of this RMU number 3 connected to an area distribution transformer, because houses needs only a small amount of power. So these houses in a barangay, they shared power on this one area distribution transformer that has an output of 430 volts that will provide power supply on the household appliances and air conditioning, etc. This RMU number 3, which is located in Barangay 1, connected to RMU number 4, which is located to a Barangay 2, through a direct burial MV cable, this red color. And then also the T of circuit of this RMU number 4 connected to the area distribution transformer that has an output of 430 volts that will provide power supply for the home appliances in Barangay number 2. This RMU number 4 connected also in RMU number 5 through a direct burial MV cable, and the T of circuit of this RMU number 5 connected to the area distribution transformer that has an output of 430 volts that can provide power supply on household appliances in Barangay number 3. So these are the components involved in feeder number 2 in providing power supply or distributing a power supply on residential area. And then this is the layout diagram, and then this is the single line diagram of the underground 13.8 kVEC distribution system using radial topology. That's all. I hope you learned something in my presentation, and goodbye. Thank you.